The point of this exercise is very important for us, also for these new editions of the portal. What we want to achieve is to have the portals as a kind of replacing us. I mean, of course, it will not be possible. When I say us, I mean EURAXESS service centers. But to the best possible extent to achieve that researchers can find the solutions to their problems and can find the answers to their questions on the portals. There are two challenges. First, to have this information on the portal, and the second one is to present it in a way so it's easy to find. And both challenges are quite big ones, and both challenges are being dealt by the specialists called information architects. And this is why we are talking today about information architects. We don't want you to become a specialist in information architecture. So we are going to just lightly touch some of the most important concepts. I mean, not a theoretical one. We are going to talk about some things, some name sign calling, some new concepts which are kind of familiar, will be familiar to you. We will give them some names so we can communicate about them and to see what we can do and how to improve what is there. Yeah, we talked about this feeling of self-accomplishment. You know, there is no better feeling than when you finish some big work and you take a look at the portals and you say to yourself, it's beautiful, it's great, that you are so proud about the work that has been done, especially if you do it for a long time in a team with a lot of contributors and so on. And I'm sure that was the case in the majority of national portals. And you say one thing, check it. But the fact is that the work is just about to begin. And the feeling of self-accomplishment is not sufficient for you to say that the work has been done. First of all, we have to hear from researchers. We have to see how they respond to the content we provided and to the way we provided it. Then we have to hear from our organizations. Then we have to hear from all target groups we are trying to address. In this training, we are going to focus on information and assistance content. We are not going to go above that. If we try to do it, it will be just too complex to do. Even information and assistance is the most complex part of the portal. I mean, most complex part of the portal, we can have some impact. We are creators of this section. We are creators of the content which is published in this section. This content is published on two channels, don't forget. Your content became a part of the website of the European Commission and takes responsibility. This is a big responsibility. It's exposed. Although there is a disclaimer at the bottom of the page when you access it through European Commission website, I mean EURAXESS website, saying that this content is produced by the National Portal Administrator, still this content is visible through the for that. So the first question in relation to the problem I put on the table at the beginning, whether researchers are capable to find this information alone without contacting you directly, is the question, is information complete for each of the sections, for each of the topics of the information assistance? Did we cover it? Sometimes, you know, when we are very busy and we have portals to develop and it's in the middle of list of our priorities, we would hurry to get the job done, but not to get it properly. I mean, it's a common thing, it's not specialty of some countries' work ethics, it's common thing in the world. And you will see this mistake everywhere, you will see this mistake in our portals as well. So did we put all the information that need to be there, so for researchers to be capable to answer these questions we want to answer, to have answer. This is important not because of the impression we make with the portal, not because of the help we provide with the portals, but also it's important for the efficiency and effectiveness of our work, the work of EURAXESS service centers. If we have more complete information is in the portal, less calls we are going to get. It's as simple as that. So it's quite beneficial for the researchers, it's quite beneficial for us to have the complete information. What makes one information complete? This is something also that we are going to think of and discuss about in this program. The question, do we have credible sources online? Many of us are using external sources of information. Not all of us can afford to have legal advisors in the EURAXESS service centers. Not for all of us is that important. We have partners, we have legal advisors in our local networks, or we just use the sources from the different governmental websites such as. Are they credible? Can we trust them? Which are other sources that we can trust? Did we even think about it? This is another question. Which information is important and which is not? Are you sure it's important to put information about the country info and put, you know, number of how big it is, how it's populated, and that stuff? I'm sure that they know already. I mean, researchers who want to come to your country. Are you sure that it's important to put information about the recreational spots? Maybe yes, if you have some special choice. Maybe yes, if you have some networking events that we are organizing there, and so on. So, we need to develop this skill to take a look at the content and to say this is important and this is not important. It's beautiful, it's great, I really like it, but it's not important. It's rather difficult. Should we maybe challenge the existing structure? It is not here, but it is here. Can we challenge the existing structure? Can we do something to improve it together? Can we make a consensus about some change request towards the recognition of the world's interest? And to finally, how to effectively present information, how to use components to present it. So basically, information architecture is something that will tell you how to achieve that users know where they are, and not only that, I mean when they are on some page of the portal, and not only that, but also to perceive where is the information they want in relation to their position. And what's important to achieve it is navigation. We have already some navigation proposal, but there is more to it because what's not so widely discussed, you can navigate for one page. And the components make it possible, you will see later. Then some metadata, how to flag what we have on the websites, how to structure them, how to structure the information we have on individual pages. So the data, actual data, what's actually searched for and asked by researchers can be accessed more easily. You will see how to use, I mean, you will hear about something called wireframes that can be also used to organize the page look and feel. And finally, categorization. Most of those things are already solved because we have this default given structure. But trust me, you can do a lot to structure it below this given default structure. Below this, three main topics and 19 topics that has been given to us as something to start with. Believe it or not, it's a lot about psychology, it's a lot about the cognitive psychology, how people perceive the content that is published in some media, and in this case in web pages. And we have to talk about to think about some different things such as cognitive load, because we heard a lot about all information overload on the internet, so it's so difficult to find some information now by using Google engines, although they are getting better and better. But also you have something like a cognitive load, which means that basically you can get overloaded by information you see in one page, because it's just too much, it's too complex. And now it's easier, because we have this new design, which is adapted, which is responsive and adapted to the presentation to this device with smaller screens. This is why it's hardly possible to get overloaded by information. But it still is. There are still examples of the pages which just have too much information. We also think about, when thinking about our users, about the researchers, we have to think about their mental models. I mean, it's psychology. Actually, and those are the assumptions we have on how the people carry some things with the websites. And these assumptions should correspond to what we foresee as the intention or the objective of our visitors. So basically, mental models teach you that information is easier to discover when it is in a place that matches the user's expectation of where it should be. So we should think about, we should look at the content by using the eyes of and the mental models of researchers and think whether they are properly placed. This is very important. I saw a lot of different approaches to how to categorize different pages, different topics within this given structure. And this is usually done by card sorting. You put all you have on the cards, and then you categorize different things and put them in different categories, and then you group the different categories if it's possible, and then out of it you make this categorization. So the first challenge I put on the structure and the EURAXESS portal, the question I got in Zagreb this training. Someone asked me after the presentation of the portal, come on, it says EURAXESS worldwide. And when I click on worldwide, it shows all these areas. But isn't Europe also in the world? Why Europe isn't there? And when you think of it, it's quite a logical question. I don't know how to respond it. The question makes sense. But it is a challenge that we are going to address in the end of the year. But this is more like illustration of that we have to think about the user's expectations, about where they're going to find some particular stuff we are expecting them to find. And these are the first decision, and they are very important. And there is a lot of decision making involved when you come to a specific page or you're addressing to a website. And the main idea of the information architecture is to give the users right decisions, proper decision choices, options at the proper time. At the proper place, of course. For example, speaking about events, when you want to add an event in Extranet, for example, you would log into Extranet and then you would open this list of the options you have on the Extranet, and you see events, you click on events and you see all the events. But there is no button for creating. And the button is on the dashboard of the Extranet, home page of the Extranet, suppose something. Yeah, on the home, this is not dashboard, this is Extranet home page. Is it on the right place, really? So were we providing a choice at the time we needed this option? I'm not sure. This is just a challenge. We can discuss about this. We can discuss also with the interest of them. It's easy thing to add the button, just create an event and the page will be met. But also the button that will be seen only by national portal administrator. It's just rhetorics. You don't have to answer these questions. I mean, these are just the example. So currently we have this three-level architecture. Living in Europe, working in Europe, living in Europe. Do you know what's it about? Do you understand the difference? This is important. I mean, because at the beginning there were many doubts on how to classify content, why we are using this additional classification, because we were not using it before. It's kind of new thing. We have these 19 topics we have been using also before. Why not keeping it? Why putting additional levels of classification? Maybe because, for example, when you come with a family, your family members will be interested in this living in Europe. They will not be maybe interested in working in Europe or living. Maybe if you're an outgoing researcher or you're finishing your contract, maybe you will just be interested in living and not in previous ones. So for me it makes sense, but you have to think it, you have to put it in the perspective of the needs of the researchers. Furthermore, we have this classification to this second level topics, like access to the culture of the host country, accommodation, banking, career development, job opportunities, and so on. You already know that those are presented in these landing pages, and you can access those pages. It will create those pages, but these pages can be accessed from two places. One location is search for information on the European portal, and the other is your menu, your national portal, if you start browsing from your national portal. Challenge! Do you know where we are now? Can you take a look at the page? The fact that the letters are small is a part of the deal, part of the question. Do you know where we are now when you take a look at this page? You typically look at the breadcrumbs. So in the breadcrumbs it says home, information assistance, then again information and assistance, then accommodation. Then with very small letters you can see that it's Cyprus. Cyprus is you know, below big accommodation, and Cyprus is in Europe. And this is the page, the layout look of the feel of the page you get when you get it from the Europe. Because if you take a look at the header, you can see that it's European portal, but it's actually Cyprus page. What to go? Where to go now? What are your options? What kind of decision making you can? You can click on Cyprus to go on Cyprus national portal to be presented with their home page. Or you can use the menu of the European portal to go for it. For me, okay, this is kind of confusing. I mean, this is worth discussing if it's possible to kind of rearrange, to put some additional labeling or some more prominent, some prominent word or label sentence that would imply that we are currently on the national portal of the Cyprus, although we are not.
Yeah. Yeah. So when I search for accommodation, then I have a list of
accommodation. Yeah.
Small country names.
You get lots of articles with the title of accommodation with a small country name. Maybe we should have established the rule that the country should be in the title. Yeah, but think about it. You know, maybe we will have some exercise. Maybe we can make a proposal how to resolve this. If you think you have some solution, think about it and please let's share this with us after the exercise. So, navigation is a key element of any site. We are going to think about the navigation from these information topics. For example, when we are talking about the navigation in this training, we are thinking about how you can navigate through your national accommodation page. What kind of information will you have there? How it's organized? Is there some information which needs more detailed elaboration? Should we put a sub-page to a landing page of accommodation? 1, 2, 3, 4. Are there some external pages to which we are going to link? And this decision is what we are making in this navigation determination phase. We're going to use a tool. It's quite, just to highlight, this picture shows a quite simple diagram. You cannot see the details, but you can see it. Does the portal work now? Okay, so if you get an opportunity to do it before your neighbor, do it. So you can, I highlighted this already before, you can navigate through one page. You have this schematic description of the page information assistance on European portal. And if you take a look closely, you will see that there are three boxes that are part of this page, living in Europe, working in Europe, and living. And these boxes are, you cannot see it on the portal, so you can maybe take a look at the screen. You don't have to read the content because it's quite small, but you will see this tab control at the stage image. And in this tab control is black and white. Black tab is currently selected, white tab is currently selected. And the labels to these tabs are living in Europe, working in Europe, living in Europe. So the content of each of these tabs is something that we consider part content block, part of the page. Not the component, but part of the page, we call it content block. And this page has three blocks. One block is the content of the tab living in Europe, the second block is content of the tab working in Europe, and the third one is content of the tab leaving Europe. And even there are some rules. And as you can see, these content blocks are marked with dashed lines. As you can see on the this schematic. If not, let's hope that you will be able to see the material quite soon on your computers. And there are some blocks, there are some squares which are with a full solid line, and those are the sub pages or special pages which links are. So you do the navigation by making a simple diagram. You have a first page, and then you have arrows leading to the blocks which are part of this page, or to the pages to which the links exist. And we are going to use a simple tool for making this diagram, and you can access it, hopefully. Just open the URL draw.io. And I will show you in a few sentences what's special about it and how you can use it. So it's draw.io. This is the app. When you open it, you will be offered the options to save what you are doing, as you can see on the screen. The easiest one is to click on device, and it means that you are saving on the local computer. And just click on create new diagram. And then, on the blank diagram, and create. So if you want, you will work with this afterwards. But just to show you, if you want to create a simple diagram, what you can do, for example, click on this rectangle and it will show up. You can drag it across the screen. You can double click it to enter some text. And for example, you can put here the name of the page for which you want to make a structure. Then you want to create a page to which there is a link from the accommodation. And let's say here put dormitories. And if you want to make this link between those two, take a look at this. When you get the pointer next to the line, you will see that there are some dots on the line axis, and when you put the mouse over the specific dot, it gets a blue circle. So at that time, you just click on the left button of the mouse, you hold the left button, and you drag this arrow to the next dot on the next square, and you just leave it. So it's the most basic way to create simple diagrams. You will be separated into groups later on, and only one member of your group will do that. The others will discuss. If you don't feel comfortable, there are some flip charts, and you can make the structures with them. But we're going to do this. So content blocks are building blocks of one page. They contain unique content or introduction to its content. And they are implemented on page by using components. So you can see the content blocks here on this part living in Europe on the page of European blog. And you can easily distinguish these two things. One is visa entry conditions and another is need help settlement. In fact, different components were used for developing these two different content blocks. One content block is visa entry condition and another one is need help settlement. One content block can consist of different content blocks because these two are part of living in Europe. This is whole tab here. There are different content blocks. Some are data blocks. Data block, something is data block if you can find answer to issue or problem or you can find complete information there. There is no need for someone to contact you when they see the content, to contact you to make it clear, to elaborate more or whatever. So everything is there. For some issues, for some types of information, it's not possible. There are teaser blocks. You cannot put everything in a simple component or page. You need additional sub-page. You need some elaboration, how to resolve some issue. So you will put the content block saying, in short, you can resolve this with this, 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 and that, and click here to get more information. So if you click it, you will get another sub-page with a complete set of information. So this block, this is why we call it teaser block. Because it has to motivate the user to click on a button to get to the full detailed information. Special kind of teaser block, mediator block. And that's it, this is the last step. Mediator block is when you have some information, additional elaboration is surely needed, but it's provided by someone else, not by you. So the additional click will not take you to a sub-page of EURAXESS portal, but to the external page. This external page can be industry association, it can be intellectual property office, it can be university, it can be government, agency, or whatever. What we did recently is to go through all national portals and get all these content blocks. And to see, to make a largest common denominator of everything that has been published by national portals. And for example, if you take a look at living in Europe, the main topics are those, accommodation, daycare, schooling, family, departure conditions, informalities, and so on. But if you take a look inside, you will find major banks, working ethics, babysitting, childcare aid and support, living costs, dispute with landlords, national holidays, pregnancy delivery coverage costs, benefits allowances of family members, pharmacies, exchanging money, private health insurance, traveler's checks, what to do in need of doctor. You know, there are 270 of these content blocks in living, working, and living here. And this is this largest common denominator. And this exercise was so important for us because we finally understood that our portal is very bad. That is missing information. Because when we took a look at everything that was provided by everybody, we established something, quite useful. I think it's going to be quite useful. Still, for some countries, some content blocks will be important, some will not. But at least you will have a bigger picture. And our objective for the exercise later on will be to write videos. Working in Europe, personal income tax, charitable income rates, avoidance of double taxation agreements, governmental schemes, supplementary pension savings, how and when to pay income tax, salaries and gender equality, coaching and mentoring, eligibility for employment benefits, transfer and time to miss accrued abroad, and so on and so on. Living Europe less topics and less content blocks, of course, but again, still interesting. How to terminate renting agreement? Did you have lots of these questions in your service centers? How to issue a certificate on professional activity? Which premises and consulate to contact? And further. More challenges arising from the, thanks to Anna, arising from the last EURAXESS conference in Den Haag. We have been a little bit, she has done some investigation among the EURAXESS members. It was quite a representative group because most of them, if not all, were members of EURAXESS service centers. And one of the challenges were, should health insurance and medical care be merged into one information topic? Actually, this question was related to statistics, but can be as well related to the portal because it's pretty much the same classification here. And great, most of them said yes, health insurance and medical care are the same topic. These two topics actually should be merged. And I can provide you evidence for that because there are lots of mix-up among the national portal, what goes where. Some people will publish topics which are links information which are generally related to health insurance, they will publish on Medicare and vice versa. So this is a good indicator that we should maybe consider merging these two topics. Should entry conditions and work permits be merged into information topic? Most of the people asked in the EURAXESS conference said yes. I'm not the kind of person that will advocate the same for the portal here, but discuss about it. Maybe yes. And the question I'm asking is what to do with access to the culture of the host country language courses. But because it became a universal topic for everything that we cannot fit anywhere. And it's really the case. So is it possible to work on it and find a way to make it, let's say, more sensitive? When you design a page, you use the pencil and the paper. This is the most conventional and most effective approach. There are tools for that, but when you develop your navigation, when you develop your individual pages and the whole sections navigations, the next thing would be to decide how the content blocks will look, how they will be ordered, how they will be organized, and you use wireframing for this. You're basically drawing the content blocks in the proper locations and even maybe drawing the layout of the content blocks. For example, for this embassies and consulate content block, I want to have a short description and a title, and I would like to have a list of collapsibles where I would put those different types of embassies and consulate block. Metadata. Difficult question. What is metadata? And when you have the answer, the answer is even more difficult, data about data. So data that describes other data. But it's basically very simple when you take a look at the EURAXESS job metadata. Metadata is our those things, daughters, those notions, those concepts to which you can write some data, some information. When you take a look, for example, let's use the metaphor of the living room. Take a look at one cabinet. The cabinet has many drawers. Many parts. And for example, there is a drawer where you can put only your socks. And this is a drawer for socks. And one metadata is a kind of drawer where you can put only one particular type of information. It has some meaning. For example, if you take a look at the EURAXESS job metadata, there is a metadata application deadline. So in this drawer, you will put only the dates which are application deadlines for the jobs. And time zones, and benefits, and eligibility criteria. Can we identify and discuss about the metadata for individual blocks? Then you have some short content. You can see it. Then you have source of data or reference. This is basically a link to which you are going to take users. And you have illustration, this is also it. So you have five information. I put something else. For whom is the content? Is this for researchers with the family? Is this for the researchers of particular stage? Is this for researchers coming from academia, or industry, or entrepreneur, or whatever? Because you will see that different content blocks will be targeting different types of researchers, different classifications of researchers. And we'll talk about this when we talk about the social media target. So, the EURAXESS. I hope that at this time you were able, at least some of you, to download we will share maybe this document in some other way. Or I will send to everybody this email, so I guess it will be with this document it will be easier to access it. Our objective of this exercise, it will take some time, is to have a perfect information in the system section for one national. And how we are going to do this? Each of the group will get one or two content topics and list of content blocks associated to each of the topics. This list of the content blocks, the possible information, will be in this document which I will be sharing. Then for each of the content blocks you will discuss. Is it necessary to have it there? Is it important? So maybe you can do some prioritization. Say this one is important, this one is not, and so on. Maybe to discuss about this one is important for this class of research, this type of research, this one is important or relevant for some other. And to ask for each of the content blocks one important question. Is it possible to make it self-sufficient for visitor to resolve a specific issue by using only content presentation? So is it possible to put some information in this content block or associated for some page and from then on to count that when somebody asks to pose the question which is associated to this one, we just say this is on the portal and this is there. You understand the question? So is it possible to put all the data necessary to resolve some specific problem which you can imply from the title of the content? It will be easier when we take a look at the list of content blocks. And how you're going to present it? Only with the data block, or only content block, and all, or whether you're going to present the sub-page, link to a sub-page, or with a link to external page. And at the end, one of you from each of the group will make the information architecture by using Draw.io tool to make this diagram with connected squares and links. Thanks, Richard.